So basically I'm going to talk about how you can promote your theme and plugin. So I actually gave a talk which was somewhat similar at WordCamp Mumbai, and when I spoke to, you know, theme or plugin developers after the talk, I realized that there was very little clarity on the who, the what, and the why. They knew they wanted to promote their product and they were very passionate about it, but there was surprisingly little clarity about, you know, what exactly they are doing. So before you set out thinking about how to promote your product, it's extremely important to know who is your customer. Is anyone who has $30 your customer? No. Be absolutely ruthless and brutal about keeping out people who will not relate to your product, right? So, yeah, so keep them out. Keep them out, keep them away from your theme or plugin. All it will result in is a lot of heartburn for the customer and for you. You really don't want them giving you their money. Yeah, so I'm a Seth Godin fan. You'll find out more. Yeah, so everyone is not your customer. So think hard, think a lot about who is your customer. Is he a developer? Is he a designer? Who exactly is your customer? Build a customer persona, if you will, in your head. And it's very important that you do that. It's only then that you will be able to talk their language and you'll be able to sort of put yourself in their shoes and think like them and think about their problems, right? The what. What exactly are you selling? Are you, because yeah, nobody cares about your product. Surprise, surprise, yeah? They care about the problem. So if I were to go out there and say, you know what, I'm selling a theme. Everybody, yeah, whatever, you know, people sell themes. But if you say you're selling the ability to set up a blog, even if you go upstairs, you know, to the 22nd floor and talk to the users who are out there, I don't know if any of you attended those sessions, but the language that they speak, the questions that they ask are very different from what we are doing here, right? And it's extremely enlightening, really, to attend some of those sessions. So if you go out there and say you're selling a theme, they don't want to talk to you so much. But if you say you have the, you know, you're going to give them the ability to set up a blog without knowing any WordPress, you're going to listen. They're going to listen to you. And why? Okay, so you've identified a problem, you know who has that problem, and you want to go ahead and solve it. Right? Don't create a product just because you can. Doesn't help. Think about why you're going to create one more plugin when there are probably millions of other plugins out there who are tackling the same problem. So think about why you, right? And then never forget that. So if you say, you know what, my product may not have so many features, just one feature, but it does that really well. It does that fast, it makes it easy, it keeps it simple, but only one feature that helps, that works. Don't try to be all things to everyone, basically. Yeah, again, Seth Godin fan, like I said. So don't find customers for your products, yeah? Build products for your customers. So we've got the who, the what, and the why. And let's talk about how. So these are some no-brainer, obvious things, right? So you have a theme or a plugin, you have a website, you build a blog, and you generate content. Again, here, while it seems like a no-brainer, you want to be smart about it, right? You want to, there are so many WordPress blogs out there, okay? There are blogs about giving you tips about what to expect in the next WordPress release. There are interviews. There are tips about how to optimize your website. What I would do if I were just starting out is to choose a niche. Like, say, for example, I would set up my blog to be, say, just about what to expect in the next WordPress release. And then I would say become the go-to place for it. So if anybody wants to know what's happening in WordPress, what's the next release about, what happened in the last release, they come to your blog. You don't want to go broad and then, you know, people don't know what to come to your website for. Suppose you do you interview WordPress personalities, then make sure your WordPress blog has all the personalities that everybody knows, right? So go, so choose a niche within that and go for it. Affiliate programs, if you're selling something, you want others to spread their word about it. But don't make them do all the hard work. So typically what I would do is, I would send out a mail to all the affiliates and tell them, you know what, you are selling our product. If you have a website and you want to talk about my product, how can I help you? Can I give you a unique write-up or a review about my product that you can then rehash and use as you will? Make it a simple, obvious thing for affiliates to promote. Make it easy for them, right? You can partner with deal sites like Mighty Deals, Deal Fuel. There are hundreds of other coupon sites as well out there. You can run giveaways. Giveaways, if you're on a low budget, collaborating with other popular WordPress blogs is a very good idea, because they are only happy to run giveaways and, you know, gain some more traction with their users as well in the process. Your admin area, again, that is one, you need to use it wisely. Don't clutter it with too much self-promotion. Give people tips on how to use your product well. That will work better than giving them coupons or giving them more promotional stuff there. Build a mailing list and give something of real value. Don't just because it's a freebie and you're giving it to them, don't just expect them to just be grateful and just give you their mail ID. Yeah? Okay, so when it comes to your website, make sure you have crystal clear navigation. On each page, decide what it is that you want, okay? When a visitor lands on your website, you either want a sale, means you want them reaching for their wallet, you want their mail ID, you want them to tell their friends about it, or you want feedback. If I get any one of these four, I'm happy, right? Once you've decided for each page what it is you want out of your visitor, be absolutely brutally focused about it. Don't get greedy. Okay? Don't try to show them, here's a deal, here's a special offer, here's a discount offer, you know what, here's a newsletter, sign up, and you know what, please share it with your friends and give me feedback. You don't want to do that. You're only going to confuse them and drive them away. So, use the premium space on your website. The online world is not so different from the offline world. So if say I had a brick and mortar store, okay, I were to have a store on the high street, and I would say, I have this wonderful new product or this new cupcake that I've launched. Okay, so where would I put it? I would put it on a banner on the street right outside my store, because that's where people will see it when they are walking in. So on your website, when they come to your website, your premium space is right on the top. Use it wisely to give visitors the most important information you want to give them. That's like putting up neon lights on your brick and mortar store. Keep it clear. Keep your website absolutely clear. Have a clear call to action, right? Make sure your visitors don't wander. These are some examples of some websites which I absolutely love. Again, here you can see, it's so obvious when they come here, you can be sure they know who their target customer is, right? They're making it amply obvious. Here's what you can do. You can convert visitors into subscribers, and you can do this without a developer. So they're amply clear who their target audience is, right? This is another one again. It's an image search site, and the key call to action there is searching for images, right? So again, they know their audience, they know what is the obvious thing that they would want to do, and they have kept only one call to action over there. Right, so you've done all this, you've tried to, you know, sell whatever it is that you're selling, and people still decide to leave. I would recommend an exit pop-up. I know it's annoying at times, and you might turn off some visitors, but you want to do it smartly. You want to be really, really smart about this. You want to see which page they are on, what it is that they were doing, and then show something to them that they will be grateful for, right? So if you give an offer, So talk to them. You can give them gated access, free trial. If nothing else works, ask for feedback. Right. And if they still leave, you can set up an automated cart abandonment process. And not in a creepy restraining order kind of way, but in a nice, you know what, hey, you know, did life get in the way? I mean, what happened? You forgot about us? Do you want to just check? I'm just checking if there was something wrong. Did you have a problem with the payment? What exactly happened? Yeah? So set up a nice follow-up email. Right. So you've done all of that. The other thing is, yeah, like it says on the shampoo bottle. So change, get feedback, repeat. Always. It's a continuous cycle. Right? And there's so many things you can do A-B testing for. It can be your CTA position, it can be colors, it can be hundreds of things. Right? Again, when you come to this, it's continuous and not endless. It's a very subtle difference, but it's important you understand, right? Say for example, how do I decide what I want to play around with or what I want to test? So what I would do is I would stick a survey on my website and say, why aren't you buying? Are the prices too high? And if I find 90% of the people are saying, yes, the prices are too high, I'm going to play around with the pricing. If I see that people are not telling me the prices are too high, I'm not going to fiddle with it, right? So use surveys to decide what you want to do your A-B testing around, right? So ask them, is it pricing that's turning you off? Is it not clear what we are doing? Is there some feature you want? Decide, ask the customers, they are the best ones to tell you exactly what you should do. So use the surveys to set up your tests and use the results to validate them. It's as simple as that. Right. And again, so I keep reminding myself, and I think it can't be said enough. Every time you make a change on your website, don't lose sight of who your customer is, what you are selling, and why you're doing it. It's very easy to get carried away when you see your competitor doing so many things so differently and you try to imitate. It doesn't help, right? So you maintain your unique identity and you'll do well. That's pretty much about me. And if any of you have any questions, yeah? No? All good? Yes. Hi, Mangu.
So, A-B testing is a very interesting topic. A-B testing is something which we're all doing, but if you, how else do you inform your decisions? Because A-B testing is just data, it's just numbers. And so if a test says something, are there other things you take into consideration? Before you implement that change, or is it just A-B test and you just change based on that?
I mean, sometimes it's gut feel, of course. I mean, I personally use a lot of that. I don't know if I can recommend it to everyone. But we do a lot of testing. For example, even with our homepage, we get 80% of our traffic lands on our homepage. And sometimes it makes us nervous when we change the homepage. Sorry, I'm messing around your camera. Sorry, I keep moving. Yeah. So we keep experimenting with the homepage as well. So sometimes if you turn up on a homepage, it's just a free theme we're giving away. Sometimes it's something else. And that is random. But with random, the thing is, you don't know. I mean, you're just shooting in the dark and it's this thing. So mostly we rely heavily, on surveys. And we have a lot of surveys which show up when somebody's about to leave or something, like a slide-in survey. And there are different surveys for different pages. So if we're giving away a free theme, we ask them, why wouldn't you upgrade? Is it because you just don't want to upgrade? Or are you afraid that your site will get messed up? Because even if they tell us that it's because they are afraid when they upgrade, their website will look completely different, that's valuable for us. Because it means we have not clearly articulated the value or the robustness of our premium theme. And that itself is huge for us. So then we want to update the pitch. We don't want to make any tests in terms of colors or pricing or anything, but we want to update that. So every single question that you ask your customers, I think that's what helps. Yeah.
anything else?
Yeah. So I've never tried A/B testing actually. How do I, what's the easiest way for me to start? Like which plugin or app can I try free possibly?
Yeah, so
how should I be testing?
Sure. So if you haven't used any plugin at all, what I would recommend is don't use a plugin. Simply change it and be brave. I mean, I don't know if it's winging it a bit, but if you haven't used a plugin, don't let that stop you. Change maybe the color of a button from red to green and see how that works for you. Just keep it on for a week and see. I mean, especially on a page where you have moderate amount of traffic, not so much that it will kill your website and, you know, change things drastically for you. But you can just make a change and see how it goes. There are lots of products out there. I mean, there's Optimizely and there are a whole bunch of products. Maybe you want to catch me offline.
Would you recommend any of those websites?
Optimizely is good. But pretty much, like I said, change it, try it. You can even make two copies of the page, say, and use Google experiments. And so Google sort of shows the two pages and you say, this is my conversion goal. And then you can, you know, based on the results of that experiment, you can decide which one stays on. So you don't need a plugin for that. If you want to catch me offline, there's plenty of stuff you can do without spending any money.
That's good.
Anything else, anyone? Yeah, that's it? Okay, thank you everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.